Good day to all. Topic work for today is all about practice of occupational health and safety procedures. Kitchen work is usually considered a relatively safe occupation, at least in comparison with many industrial jobs. Nevertheless, the kitchen presents many hazards. Minor injuries from cuts and burns are common, and more serious injuries are all into possible. The quantity of hot equipment and powerful machinery combined with the busy, sometimes frantic pace make it important for everyone to work carefully and with constant attention to the rules of safety. Food hazards. Preventing foodborne illness is one of the most important challenges facing every food service worker. In order to prevent illness, a food worker must understand the source of foodborne disease. Most foodborne illness is the result of eating food that has been contaminated. To say a food is contaminated means it contains harmful substances not originally present in it. In other words, contaminated food is food that is not pure. In this section, we first discuss the various substances that can contaminate food and cause illness. Afterward, we consider how these substances get into food to contaminate it and how food workers can prevent contamination and avoid serving contaminated food. Any substance in food that can cause illness or injury is called a hazard. Food hazards are of four types. Number one, biological hazards, as you can see in the picture. Number two, hazards. Okay, number three, physical hazards or allergens. The eight major food allergens: milk, egg, fish, shellfish, wheat, soybeans, peanut, and tree nuts. Notice it has said most foodborne illness is caused by eating food contaminated with foreign substances. Some illness is caused not by contaminants but by substances that occur naturally in food. These include plant toxins, toxin means poison, such as the chemicals in poisonous mushrooms, and certain natural food components to which some people are allergic. This section considers all these kinds of food hazards. The safe workplace. Structure, equipment, and electrical wiring in good repair. Adequate lighting in work, surface, and in corridors. Non-slip floors. Clearly marked exits, equipment supplied with necessary safety devices, heat-activated fire extinguishers, overcooking equipment, especially deep-fry. 7. Conveniently located emergency equipment and such as fire extinguishers, fire blankets, and first aid kits. 8. Clearly posted emergency telephone numbers. 9. Clearly posted emergency procedures including the Helmlich maneuver for victims of choking. 10. Smooth traffic patterns to avoid collision between workers. Okay, thank you for watching.